Hey guys, and welcome back to another video. Today's video, as mentioned, we're talking a lot about relational databases. We're going to be working on a problem that I'm suffering from and hopefully fix it with relational databases. I sort of touched on it in one of the previous videos I did, but I didn't really go into detail. And this weekend I actually have been sitting down and learning about more about how I could adopt it. So hopefully this video can be applicable to you and shows a few of the features that the databases uses. So guys, just before we dive in, I've got a list in front of me of the five winners of the 50k giveaway. The 50k giveaway was with lots of prizes, and it was just a appreciation of you guys for reaching 50k subscribers on this YouTube channel. So thank you very much, and here are the winners. So the first winner will be Gadget Gav. Second winner is Dimitri Kamaritis. I'm going to butcher people's names here. Next, third winner is K. Marnix Omen, and also Sebastian Tello, and also Christian Margiloman. I'm really sorry if I ruined anyone's names there. You guys are winners, so I will be messaging you separately for winning that big bundle of prizes for 50k. We'll do another giveaway at probably 100k, so maybe sometime later next year. Also be doing giveaways blended with other videos, so do not worry. So as I mentioned, guys, today's video, we're diving into Notion relationship databases. I am fixing a specific problem with my workouts experience. I want to be able to tally workouts, but have them in a more responsive manner in my health dashboard. So hopefully this video gives you a full outline. So let's jump over to the Mac. So guys, in the last Notion video, what we did is we looked into my workout routine and health dashboard, slightly at the end of the video, talking a little bit about relational databases. Now, what I want to do in this video is explain how to create a relational database and how it can be useful in an everyday routine or a project that you may be working on. So in this demonstration, I'll be taking my health dashboard, which is available here. Talked briefly about it before, what I was doing with it. So previously what I was doing with it is I add a new tally for the day. I'll add in sleep time, meditation, whether I did it or not. I also add out what I workout I did, and also how much time that is, a food rating, and also how much time I spent on Audible. Now, I do this pretty infrequently, so maybe every 2 days, roughly, and I've started at the start of November, although deleted some past dates. Now, the real idea of this is to make it almost a tally of how I can improve, like giving me a sleep medium time so that I can really try and improve on the hours of sleep I get, and also the meditation, being able to track how many times I've done meditation. But primarily I want it to be a place where I can tally my workouts and my food. So previously what I did with my workouts is I created a relational database, a property type here. So I can just go to this one and click relational. Basically, this is connected up with a database that I had previously called Workout Log. And the Workout Log, if we go back to the home, you can find it over in the bottom right, was essentially me plotting out on a database calendar all of the dates and times that I did my workout. So for example, last week, last Tuesday, for example, I did a boxing and core workout that took me 30 minutes. And I used to just plot them here. And then I recently started to use the relational calendar, or sorry, the relational database property type inside of here to link them up. And then do a lookup here, or a roll up, sorry, to be able to count how much time spent. So what I want to do in this video is actually change the way I do that. I want to create a new database that tallies the workouts that I do, the types of workouts, so that I don't have to associate these to dates. So for example, whenever I was finding one of these, I would go in and I'd have to search for the date that I did it on. So for example, in this case, it was the 23rd. I'd have to look, okay, where's the 23rd of November? I think I did it on 23rd of November. It should be around here. In this case, there it is. Workout A, and I press plus and it adds it to it. And then it imports the 30 minute timer. So what I want to do is I want to create a relational database from scratch, show you how to import it. So what we're going to do is delete these properties here and we're going to create them from scratch. So let's dive over to the workouts area. So I'm going to click workout routine. So this is the area where I store my workout routines at the moment. And the goal is to basically now have a list of workout routines that I can go and implement. These are something I was playing around with last night. So I'm going to get rid of a few of these. I'm going to drag them onto here because these are not benchmarks, but they're like challenges that I want to do. So I can do that separately in the future. So I can say here, workout menu. A workout menu, here we go. So I've got the pull strength workout, which is this one here. So I can, if I've got this one inside of here, so if I open it up and check that it's in there, then I can get rid of this down here. And I'll do the same for these two up here. So these are two other simple workouts that I've got here, version workout A and workout B. And they're really simple, like blend of cardio and core. So you're probably wondering here, why do you need these in some sort of workout menu? Well, they're recently added workouts that I've started to use inside of Notion. And the reason why I use them so much is that I pretty much press open when I'm in the gym and follow the step by step. So for example, do a deadlift, do a bench over row, and I can follow that very to the point. And it's quite a good way in me being able to keep track of everything. So in this case, I'm just gonna give this one a quick icon. Let's just put the bike, because I guess there's some spin bike in there. And I'm gonna put the time taken is normally around about 25 minutes, let's say. And it's also like more focused on core than it is, let's say, upper. So I'm gonna go and do this one for workout B2. Okay, so there we go. I've pretty much got the workouts laid out, and maybe I can get rid of that and just call it pull strength. But you can see here, I've basically got the name of the workout. I've got the time taken for each workout, the type of body area it covers. And essentially that's going to be my workout menu now. The goal behind this is so that I can have almost a menu that I can go into, follow as I'm at the gym, and be able to tally which ones I did. So previously, as I mentioned, I pretty much just added them in here. I'm not going to be doing that now, so I don't really need this one anymore. What I'm going to be doing is adding this as a relational database inside of the health dashboard. So as mentioned, that was a table inside of the workouts area. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new column, and I'm going to call it workout, and I'm going to drag it over to here because that's where I originally had it, just in between meditation and food. Now I'm going to go down here and change the property type to relation. It's going to ask me what database I should bring in. So I'm going to type in menu, which it was titled at, and create relation. So now basically it's linked up. So essentially if I'm like, okay, I need to tally, then I did core, I believe I did core on that day. I can go down here and see all of the different workouts that I've got on my options, and there was a time taken and tags as well. So I'm gonna say I did a little bit of boxing. I think I did, no, I actually did workout A that day. And if I press enter, you can see that workout A appears here. Now the real magic is where I want to start tallying up the amount of workout time that I had. So let's say here, property type, I go to roll up, and I make this a little bit smaller because it's only just a quick number. I'm going to relate it to the workout area because at the moment that's the only existing relationship here. I'm gonna choose the time taken tag. And what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna use sum, which I'm gonna come back to in a bit later on in this feature. So for example, if I did two types of workouts then, if I did a boxing one too, what I could do is I just add that one to there. And as you can see, boxing and workout appear, and the sum of, or both of those workouts appear together. So I've got both boxing and workout A tallying to 60 minutes of time. Now, what I might want to do as well is be able to add a separate column of just a very simple how much walking time I had during the day. So I've got a separate field here called walk time. Now, basically what I want to do is start adding the amount of time I spend walking. So that could be 12 minutes that day. And let's just set 12 minutes that day, just so that if I go on a walk, I can be able to tally that too. Now, this is where the formula magic comes in. I'm going to type in total fitness time, and I'm going to give that one a property type of formula. So formula, this will be able to hopefully tally up all of the most important information here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to press enter, and this appears in the top right. Now, what something I want to state is that I'm not a master in formulas, and I'm actually learning them. I was learning a bit over the weekend, but only to the point where I'm going to demonstrate this. I will be doing more videos on this, so do stay tuned for it. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to choose the workout time because that's where the roll-up appears. And then I'm going to go and hit plus and then add walk time. What I'm going to click then is done. And you can see here that a simple formula has been able to, whatever I do and change inside of here, so let's say I didn't do boxing, it can automatically change the time, the fitness time that I've done so far. So it's quite a neat way of being able to bring everything together. So maybe I need to change that to total fitness time, TFT, and drag that down. So I can see a nice indication of, let me just neaten these up. I can see a nice indication really clearly of how much time I've done during the day. So I can start from today and actually click that one there, and I can be like, okay, I slept, I think I slept 8 hours, which is pretty good. Did meditate this morning, and when I do a workout, I can start to begin to tally all of that. When I do a walk, I can do all of that. And that's a nice way to be able to use the formula. Now, hopefully that made sense. As you can imagine, it takes a bit of time. One thing I want to do in the future is play around a little bit more with formulas, because once I learn how to do the true and false stuff and the more detailed stuff, I could potentially have a good go of it. And when Notion releases the API, I think that's when it's going to get proper exciting. Anyway, guys, hopefully that gave you a nice introduction to the relational database design stuff. It's really easy. A relational database can connect with any of the databases, whether it's a table, whether it's a calendar, inside of your Notion account. And it's really easy to get going once you get going. So just have a play around with it. That's my recommendation. See where it can really connect with your daily routine. What I would say is use it like a menu initially. Like here, I'll be able to see all of the different types of stuff I've done so far. And I can pick out and add it to it versus necessarily, versus necessarily having unique setups like I did have before, unique values in there, something that that would be a recommendation from me. Anyway, guys, a big thank you for stopping by today. Hopefully in a few weeks you'll be able to see this fully populated. But without further ado, guys, thank you very much for stopping by today. A little short message to finalize everything.